Let me invite Jenlyn Eubanks up front. She's going to be graduating at the end of the semester. I'm going to pursue a career in healthcare writing. Two other writers who bridge the gap that she stands across between the literary and scientific worlds, Mary Shelley and Michael Crichton, are the subjects of her Capstone paper titled "I Think, Therefore I Possess an Ego: Psychoanalyzing Humanity's Unconscious in Disaster Fiction."
From Frankenstein, and the other is Julia Foreman. They both provide sanctuary and care for their children, and they also interact with their children on a regular basis. And they allow children to understand their larger purpose in society. Which brings us to the symbolic, the speech, the language, culture, masculine, the father. And this is where I tied in Victor Frankenstein and Jack Foreman. Another thing that I forgot to mention in the first slide is that Bernie Wrightson, actually one of my friends told me about this comic, but I really want to get it. It has Frankenstein as well as like descriptions and illustrations of Frankenstein's characters and such. So that's why I have that black and white picture right there. They both, Victor and Frankenstein, Dr. Victor Frankenstein, design the children. In Victor's case, it's through body parts, like sewing them together and bringing his monster to life. And for Jack, it's the symbolic chain of meaning, which is the code that he creates for the nanotechnology. They tie creations to society with language, such as, I'm going to use the term name of the father from Jocelyn Khan. They adopt their father's language to make their desires real. And the third and final realm is the realm of the real. It's really tough to pinpoint what the real is. I have that it exists before language, mental models, and cultural codes. Of course, it comes before language. Mostly, it's unattainable to all of us since we already have our language. It's also like absolute being, instinctual, our needs and behaviors, and our desires. And I related these real characteristics to the monster and the nanotech swarms. Both of them are instinctually dependent on their needs and their satisfaction in the wild. In their wild environments. And they're able to adapt, observe, and innovate solely in their surroundings without much need of communication at all. At first, I don't want to give any spoilers, so that's another reason that I'm saying like to the real realm, and it's basically helping our imaginary symbolic and real concepts. Now, psychosis of humanity. Yes, I changed the doctor to the psychoanalyst is in that picture. So, what I can say is that Lacan's concepts cannot only be applied to Frankenstein and Prey, but they can also be applied to humanity as well. It is true that psychoanalysis is mostly for humanity in general, but I thought that it'd be interesting to apply it to characters in Prey and Frankenstein. The imaginary, symbolic, and the real also signify the relationships between nature, knowledge, and humanity. In a broad sense, novels such as Frankenstein and Prey allow society to ruminate on possibilities of scientific disasters. And when humanity reflects on its behavior and how it affects the natural world, there's a larger understanding which connects nature and man, a joint appreciation of life, survival, and discovery. Now I have some closing thoughts on my whole capstone this semester. I thoroughly enjoyed psychoanalyzing the main characters in Frankenstein and Prey because I love noticing connections between fictional characters and how they connect to the real world. I also immensely enjoy science-oriented themes and modern innovation. While writing my capstone, my thesis continued to evolve even after my proposal was completed. It's true. So don't be afraid of that happening. However, I eventually captured it. Although it took me some time to figure out what my intentions were, that constant change was needed to establish the premise of my capstone. Now I'm going to go back to my roots a little bit. In closing, I'll share a personal and sentimental discovery. A few weeks ago, I stumbled across a video which I recorded on January 31st, 2012. Surprisingly, one sentence reflects how I have felt while attending classes at PNC, and also how I feel about graduating at the end of the semester. This is the big jump. This is what counts, and this is what is going to change my life. Honestly, I used to fear everything having to do with change, but it only took brain surgery to help me change my mind.